One of the more popular features of Data Link is the ability to add a trend control similar to that of Process Book into a spreadsheet and have that trend control behave as if you were looking at a Process Book display. To do this, we're going to put a trend inside this spreadsheet. I'm going to select Pie and Insert Trend. And this is one of the only features in Data Link that actually has a wizard. A wizard is one of these functions that steps you through various dialog boxes. And you can see at the top, you can have data on the worksheet or data from Pi or in your trend. I'm going to have both appear in my trend to show you how this works. And if I select data from worksheet, what I need to do is select a range of cells that have both a recognizable timestamp and a value. And I click Add to add that to my elements in my trend. Now, if it is an array of data, you can have it pick up the entire array. And if you do want a stepped plot and not interpolated, you can have that function as well. I'm also going to get data from Pi by doing a simple tag search. And the tag search I'm going to do is for my CDT tag that I've been using. And I will use the CDT tag from CDT 158 for my local host. And if I want to actually show the values on the trend, I need to select markers. And you can adjust their order in the list and whatnot here. You click Next, and it's going to ask you what you want to use as the time for the trend. Now, you can either use a hard-coded time, as we've shown here. I could use one of the Pi time abbreviations, as I'm typing in here. Or you can use cell references by clicking on these buttons and then indicating which cell you wanted to use. I'm going to enable updates because I want my trend to be live. I'll click Next, and the only thing really left to do is give the trend a title. You don't have to give a trend a title, but you can if you'd like. And click Finish. And what you'll see when you look at your trend is all of the data from the worksheet and all of the data from your Pi system. One of the nice features about the trend control is that it does show questionable annotations and the substituted flag on the trend object itself. When you have a trend in an Excel spreadsheet, one of the things you have to realize about the trend is that it doesn't have any of the toolbar buttons that Process Book has. And because of that reason, in order to control the trend, we need to have a mechanism in place to do that. And the way you do that is through the right click. When you right click on the trend, anywhere on it, all of the functions that you can do to the trend appear in the context menu. So if I wanted to, for some reason, add a scroll bar to this trend so I could go back and forth in time, I could have that appear on my trend. I can turn that off by simply right-clicking and unchecking the box. If I want to zoom in on this trend, I can do that as well. To revert back, I simply right-click and revert. One of the other popular functions is export data. If I wanted to export the data from my trend onto my spreadsheet, I simply give the spreadsheet a starting point for my data. I want to use the trace name as the heading and click OK. And you can see that I have data here that's from my spreadsheet and I have data here that's from my Pi server. So the export data function is one of the nice functions about this. If you want to change the formatting or the definition of the trend, you can select that within the right menu as well. So I can change any of the features of my trend, including the formatting of the trend, and this would include things like trace colors. You can see the trace color I have is the first trace color is green, my second trace color is blue. You have different options on the formatting and whatnot, so you have a lot of control over the visual aspect of the trend itself.